हमारे जो मॉडरेटर है वो क्वेश्चन जो टेकअप करेंगे वो कहाँ से करेंगे? रिटन पहले चैट में क्वेश्चन
वो फेसबुक से आ रहे हैं,
यानी मॉडरेटर के पास वहाँ पर फेसबुक का लिंक भी खुला हुआ होना चाहिए।
जी।
As and your job increases,
इंशाल्लाह सर। वेटिंग फॉर कुछ पार्टिसिपेंट्स का वेट करना है और कोई वेटिंग रूम में है?
मजीद साहब और वहाँ कादरी साहब,
जिस तरह गए लॉकडाउन था इस तरह शायद और भी लोग लॉकडाउन हो।
नहीं सर, स्पीकर रूम में सिर्फ हम लोग होंगे सर, सिर्फ मजीद साहब तो आ गए ना।
मजीद साहब आ गए। सलाम सर, सर आपका माइक अनम्यूट कर लें। मजीद साहब
सर,
सलाम
वालेकुम। जनाब कैसे हैं
सर? खैरियत से बस सर, वी गोइंग लाइव इन अबाउट 30 सेकंड्स।
ओके राइट,
थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग अस सर, लुकिंग गुड।
मोस्ट वेलकम। जस्ट overeating and recovering from corona and
you had a very tough time sir, I know.
there you are, that's life.
Assalamu alaikum everybody, welcome to the second webinar of the series of webinars being hosted by Bakai Medical University on the topic of online teaching assessment effective engagement.
That's right. Aur aap theek?
We have today a galaxy of panelists, four panelists who I'm going to introduce gradually, each one of them. The first I'm going to introduce is Professor Ejaz Hassan Khan. He's at the moment principal of Northwest Medical School of Medicine. Professor Ejaz is a graduate of Khyber Medical College, and he did his MPhil and PhD from the Armed Forces Institute of Pathology, Rawalpindi, in pathology. He also served as principal of Khyber Medical College and professor of pathology. He then joined the Northwest Medical College and has been heading an institution. An additional feature that Ejaz Saab has, or an additional qualification, he's got a diploma in medical education and administration. So, Professor Ejaz, welcome to our webinar. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Next, I move to another esteemed personality, a mentor of mine, Professor Abdul Majeed Chaudhary. Professor Majeed Chaudhary is probably one of the most senior, seasoned educationists and educators around. He is a graduate, you'll be surprised, of Liaquat College of Medicine and Dental, which is used to be, you know, Jamshoro. And he then he did his fellowship back in 1973 from Edinburgh in surgery.
And 78.
So thank you for correcting me. And he did his master's in medical education from Holland in 2008. He's been the principal of Fatma Jinnah Medical. He's in fact been the chairman of Department of Surgery at King Edward Medical University. And then he was principal of Fatma Jinnah Medical College for 3 years before he moved to Lahore Medical and Dental College, which he's been heading since 2010. Sir, it's an honor to have you on the webinar.
Thank you very much. Honor is mine.
Thank you, sir. Next, I move to Professor Wahab Khadri. Wahab Saab is going to rejoin us. He was here, but he's going to rejoin, probably some connectivity issue. He's a graduate of Bakai Dental College in 1999. And then he did his FCPS in oral and facial maxillary surgery in 2007. At the moment, he is principal Beria Medical University and Dental College of the dental section. And he's a keen educator who takes a lot of interest in education activity. Finally, I come to a personality whom we know very well, Professor Iftikhar Ahmed, who's a graduate again from the same place Professor Majeed Chaudhary graduated from, Liaquat Medical College, Jamshoro. Professor Iftikhar is an MPhil in biochemistry and then a PhD in biochemistry as well. He's not only the principal of Bakai Medical College, but he is also the Dean, Faculty of Basic Sciences of Bakai Medical College. And he's again once a keen person, he takes a keen interest in medical education. So that is our panel. Our moderator who will be fielding the questions is Dr. Asan Sethi, who does not need an introduction. So Asan, I would request you to introduce yourself so that my burden becomes a little less. So Asan, if you can hear me.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone, especially Dr. Professor Mujee Chaudhary Sahab, Dr. Ijaz Hassan Khan, Dr. Wahab, and Dr. Iftikhar Ahmed. So I am Dr. Asan Sethi. I'm working at Khyber Medical University in medical education, also providing some consultation to Bakai Medical University. And Dr. Shams initiated the idea. So we have been working together in organizing these webinars every now and then. So looking forward to have a fruitful discussion from all of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Asan. Basically, what we faced was what we call a knee-jerk reaction when the COVID pandemic suddenly stopped all medical, dental, colleges, universities from teaching face-to-face. And a lot of us were probably prepared. Majority of us were probably half prepared, but a lot of us needed to prepare ourselves. So that was the background which we faced back in March. And I remember vividly the day when we were all looking at it and we were wondering, when would this pandemic end? And as we've come to realize, this pandemic is going on for a further period as well. So we initiated online readiness. The HEC was kind enough to give us guidelines for online readiness, which we achieved. And then we started teaching online. Now, the quality of teaching has varied. That is what we accept. And the reason it varies, there was a lot of issues which are beyond our control as educator and educationist. Connectivity issues, students not ready with their devices, because we found a lot of solutions which were not applicable in our relevant settings. So we looked at our own settings and we realized the people who really mattered were what we call stakeholders, and who were the educators, the educationists, the students, their parents. So we initiated the first webinar with four panelists who are mainly educationists, and we looked at their perspective. This webinar is based on the perspective of the principals. Now we have Professor Ijaz Hassan, who's heading Northwest Medical College. Then we have Professor Iftikhar, who's heading Bakai Medical University Medical College, which is a private setup. Again, Northwest is a private setup. Then Dr. Wahab Khadri, who comes from a dental background. And Majid Chaudhary, who is extensive in both in the public sector and in the private sector. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put questions initially to Professor Ijaz Saab, then Professor Majid Chaudhary, the same question, Iftikhar Saab, and then Wahab Khadri Saab, to see what their perspective is. So Ijaz Saab, if you'd be kind enough to, as a principal, we would request your perspective as to the challenges faced by the faculty in the regard of online readiness, the solutions that were provided to you by the higher management, and how the innovation and adaptation was done at your level to facilitate the engagement in teaching and learning at your level. Thank you, Ijaz Saab.
Thank you very much, Shan Saab. I'm really honored to be part of this panel. And I am proud that Asan Sethi is the moderator, who happened to be my student in undergraduate and my teacher in MHP. So very proud moment. Actually, as they say, Karenge Ahle Nazar Taza Bastiyan Abad. So when Northwest was being established in 2016, so there was a futuristic vision. We have our own customized software, VLE, virtual learning environment. And most of the things we were already doing with the student beside actual face-to-face teaching. So the VLE was facilitating the curriculum mapping. The lectures were also uploaded on that. The assessment was also partly done on that. The teacher's online assessment was done on that. Library management system was also placed on that. So when this pandemic started in the end of February, we realized that it is going to come here. We never thought that this thing will happen, that the institutions will be closed, but we thought something may happen. So we tried to be more innovative and expand upon our own resources. Some of our teachers were of the view that we should be using Zoom, we should be using Microsoft Teams and things like that. But we thought that we may take the help of those things, but first we have to place our own house in order. So we want to improve. So what we did that, the institutions were closed on 16th of March. Before that, we did workshops for our faculty as well as for our students to get them ready for online teaching. And we started, and I think we must be among the few of institutions of this country who started their online teaching from 18th of March this year. So that's why we were able to cover our course. Now we are on our revision classes. We mostly used our own virtual learning environment in which initially the lectures were recorded and they were uploaded. Later on, we shifted to a discussion forum. We opened a discussion forum on that so that the student can ask questions and they can be discussed. And in the revision part, we went on the Zoom lectures. As you said about what are the problems and what are the solution, first problem was communication gap. So for that, what we did that we opened a discussion forum and we activated it. So the discussion between the administration and the faculty, as well as the students. Then there were accessibility issues. So for the, especially for the students who are living in the remote areas of the province, that is Fata and other nearby the tribal areas. So what we did that we audio and video recorded the lectures for them so they can see those. There were few, but we thought that we should care for everyone. Then another problem was a lack of computer knowledge. Even in this era, there are few students. Even in the 100, if two students are lacking the computer knowledge, they do matter for us. So what we did that we introduced audio and video tutorials for these students. And we have our future plan also because we have learned from this pandemic that constantly innovative and additions should be constantly done. So this is how we, and we, I think, successfully, because we are satisfied personally as administrator, I am satisfied, the faculty is satisfied. Though the student always, wherever they are, they want to remain in a comfort zone, besides few good students, but still they are satisfied. So I think this is something which I've learned from my teachers like SNCT. So this is what happened here.
Thank you, Ajaz Sahab, very well put. I think what advantage you had, you were kind of half prepared with the virtual learning and system yes, you already yes. had. So you used that to effect, but you initially used asynchronous methods and then you went to synchronous method. So that's a good innovation adaptation. Sir, the same question to Professor Majid Chaudhary. I know, sir, you were out with COVID for the last month or so. You had a tough time and we kept in touch. But before that, you were heading Lahore Medical Indian College, and I know you brought in a lot of innovations in the teaching. So your perspective on the same situation, sir.
Thank you very much, everybody. Assalamu alaikum. And, assalamu alaikum to all the medical educationists, because, it has been my weak point in this country. Maybe just for the knowledge of my panelists, I was the first Pakistani professor to do MHP from University of Maastricht and started a lot of courses around the country, including I helped Dow University, I helped Khyber University. I started myself with the MHP program at the University of Health Sciences, Lahore. And, I have been like principal for the Lahore Medical Dental College for the last about 10 years.
I think we're facing connectivity issues. I think Majid Saab is facing I would suggest we move to Wahab Khadri Saab, because Majid Saab, we have a little connectivity issue from your side. We'll take you on board, sir, soon again. Wahab Khadri Saab, I would like your views, especially when you were facing the issues from a different angle, because your administration is slightly different, your higher administration.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone, and thank you for having me in this August gathering, sir. I see all my teachers here. Coming back to this situation, this grappled the world, actually, aur hum sabko usne involved kiya by emergency. So initially, we started our online teaching thing as an academic engagement program with these students. This is 9th of March. And utilizing some tech-savvy people like myself and other my younger colleagues in the faculty thought that let's start something. My university, as you just mentioned, already has an LMS system, that is a learning management system, which is like working in all domains. And we were in the process of getting it in the medical and the dental sections. But the social sciences were very much climatized. My IT department was very well used to it. So we started up with limited engagement with Zoom. This is 9th of March. And students also started enjoying it. And so we took it to the next level. And within 3 weeks, that is 2 weeks, I should be saying, on 21st of March, we were actually conducting regular lectures. And the regular lecture part... In the regular part, what we faced was initially that faculty was so much enthusiastic that they started teaching slightly more than what we students could gather. And students at the same time were initially, yes, I would not go into the same detail as Professor Ijaz has rightly pointed out, the connectivity issues and all the logistic issues that everyone was facing. Our students in Karachi did not have that kind of issues, but people in the peripheries actually started complaining about this factor right at the beginning. So we were actually with them. We have a mentoring system. We went one-on-one on them. Okay, kis tarike se we have to manage and look into those things. And we finally got everything in place in the end of, towards the end of March, that is 21st, 23rd March. We were pretty much ready for all those things. And then our university, through HEC, obviously, was facilitated with the MS Teams program. And once from Zoom, we shifted to MS Teams, which is a very elaborate program. And having all the tools and everything, it was a fully paid program. So we had access to all the applications that it gives us. So that was the time that we started regularly. Our online academic council was formulated. We had the curriculum things which were given to the student in the form of a study guide right at the beginning. We started following that. And we actually developed a weekly timely schedule, which was given to the students beforehand. Usme bhi humne do teen cheeze faculty ke liye khayal rakha. Timing was of key importance. When to start and when to finish. Because initially everyone was skeptical ke mujhe ye time chahiye, mujhe wo time chahiye. But then we fizzled it out. I'm just going step by step how we actually entered into the fully developed program. And by the end of March, I would say that is the 30th of March, probably that is the date, where we actually had a full-fledged designated program in a manner. We switched from initial phase and there was regular timetable that were being followed. All the faculty was trained before that. We set up a studio sort of situations in our library, which was for all the faculties. All the classrooms were set up. So initially faculty used to come to college for their lecture parts, initially for training part. And once they got trained in a week or so, they actually all opted out, work from home, which was the objective of the whole exercise. And once we got into that, we never looked back. And alhamdulillah, class sessions are being taken now, or we use all the synchronous teaching and asynchronous teaching. Yani humne live kiya, and we were uploading all the struck material to the in the form of handouts and videos for, and some in the form of videos so that can be discussed. Then CBLs were introduced immediately. Then PSILs were conducted. Also, small quizzes were conducted. And small group discussions actually is something that students actually enjoyed, because the feedback that we received was that we are actually getting more of information, and that we can always go back and look at it back again whenever we want to have, because they are recorded in the form of recordings available to them also. So that is it for the beginning. And if anything I've missed out, maybe later we'll cover it. Dr. Shams can help me out.
Thank you, Dr. Wahab. Really appreciate it.
Sorry, I think there was a telephone call and it got disconnected. You know, I'm sitting in the city of Faridabad, recovering and in convalescence. So, right. Now, we started around middle of August. As I told you that we have about 30 medical educationists in our institution. We have a very, very robust faculty training program in our institution. And it's mandatory for everybody to have certain workshops, which we conduct virtually fortnightly or every month in our institution. So that's one thing. The other thing is that our faculty was honestly trained already. We just had, because we anticipated on around 12th of March that if we were all geared up, both for MBBS and BDS students. I hear one gentleman is a dental.
Wahab Saab is dental.
That's me, sir.
Acha, Wahab Saab, I have some connection with dentistry in the sense that I taught dental students for about 15 years at King Edward, and wrote actually a book as well for dental students. But anyway, so we started with the lectures. Even before this, there was a lot of online communications, I wouldn't say teaching, going on between the faculty and the students. So we started with the lectures and then kept on adding. Every single subject is different. So they had their own meeting, faculty meetings every week, and they modify their strategies as required in the line of feedback which we get from the students. That's number one. And then every couple of weeks, every 2 weeks, I have a meeting with all the heads of departments to find out their difficulties, because we have a very, very well-developed IT department. Just for the information, we have a website, which is being utilized virtually everywhere in the world. It's called lmdcdigital.com. If kindly note it down, it's a free download for anybody. Everybody, I know thousands of medical students in India, Nepal, Sri Lanka, they are using it. lmdcdigital.com. It has virtually everything from operations to lectures to photographs to whatever we